Welcome to another beautiful episode of Music is Critical TV. We on episode 18. We grown now, almost.
We almost made it legal.
Can't buy us a drink yet, but you can come fuck with us. You feel me? Like, you really on some shit right now. You feel me? Like, you feel me? It's episode 18, and we missed a week. We missed a week because, you know,
they ain't doing shit.
Nah, you know, some behind the scenes stuff been happening. We just had to get everything together. But I apologize for that personally from the DON, the one, not the two, to you. That rhymes too. But, oh, and y'all, a couple of people have been sending me music. I'm like, yo, bro, what you think? I don't care about your music. So don't send it to me. Unless you introduce yourself and be like, yo, I'm this and I think I like your podcast, but don't just send it to me because that's weird.
It is.
Like, I replied to one dude, but it was cool. But just talk first, then send me the music.
Like,
but it's your boy, BD, the D-O-N, the one, not the motherfucking two.
Hey, who start calling you BD first?
Yeah, who did? You did? Yeah. You gave my name? I didn't know that.
Honestly, we were talking, he was like, you need to change your name to, you know.
That's my, I know that.
Like, yeah.
We ain't never told
him
that.
I don't think I ever did say tell him. Yeah, for sure.
We hear it first, right now.
That's
critical, you know what I'm saying?
What's up, man? It's your boy, Dejon Michaels, man. We in the building.
And your boy, Edison.
And we got a special guest in the building. Y'all already probably know who this dude is already, man.
CEO.
I don't even need no introduction. He don't need no introduction.
Nah, nigga, he get out.
I'm about to still introduce the bro.
He coming out.
Get him, champ.
My boy, Joey Fats in the building,
my bro. EBK shit, anybody get it. No, I don't politic, I'm no politician. I might just chalk him out, bet you this carbon go bring the corners out. You talking loud, but ain't trying to bite. Then what that bark about, my niggas wild. Catch you, I slip in front of your bitch's house and do you foul. Hollow tips hit you and blow your noodles out. Hash gang, shoot a gang, kill whoever choose to hang. Without a face, without a name, without a gun, without a case. Fresh up out the county jail for cracking at a nigga place. Just got off a tour, bitch, my name is packing another state. 100 G's in the safe, tend to get them out the way. Probably could have bought a Wraith, instead I bought a 100K.
Day one shit. So we gonna do it how we always do it, bro. You feel me? That's just kicking regular conversation that we already
regular
have.
Combo.
You feel me? Oh, regular bro conversation, my nigga. You feel me? Just in front of the only difference is a camera shooting in front of
me. Yeah, because he's been back here plenty of times.
Plenty of times.
Talking, you feel me? But
this
it's just
a camera now. You
y'all
me?
Here with us now. So you feel
gonna,
me? But at the end, we're going to get to.
I'm high than a motherfucker right now.
Yeah, it's all
I'm
good.
I'm a little high too.
Right? I ain't high, but I'm faded off the hen dog.
Okay, mister. No drugs.
That's a drug, though.
But they say drug, it is.
That is a drug. It just got to kind of live because of prohibition. But anyway.
Okay, prohibition.
It is, that's true.
Big
that's
word.
A fact.
You learned that from high school history class.
Nigga from prohibition.
No. Somewhere. But anyway,
that good tech in the cup, you know what I'm saying?
No tracer over here. We just taking it straight.
No ice.
Straight
no
lean.
Ice.
You know what I mean? Look at that red dot, nigga.
We taking it straight.
That's like
here.
That six in a cup.
You see them bubbles? No ice.
We taking
no
it straight.
Ice.
No tracer.
We taking
out
straight
here.
Lean, nigga. Ain't no soda in here.
He said straight lean.
The drop. Right.
Hey, but so look, we're going to dive right into this, bro. The little
we gonna get that first.
Aisha Curry shit, man. I know y'all been hearing about what she
that's
said.
How you pronounce her name? I thought it was Aisha Curry.
I thought it was Aisha.
I mean, I heard her name before I seen it on paper, so I'll just say what I
would
heard.
You
it was Aisha.
Aisha.
Aisha Curry.
Okay,
Aisha.
We gonna say A. Curry. Mrs. Curry, shit. What Mrs. Curry said on Red Table Talk was basically she's lacking male attention. She's
male?
Lacking that male
she's
attention.
She's proof that a woman would never be satisfied.
Oh, hey, that's
hey,
a
yeah,
good.
Cause she got it. Her husband is the best shooter in the motherfucking
he's a
world
square.
For life.
He don't go out.
Talking wow. about that.
He don't go out. He's got money.
Mm-hmm.
You're happy. The relationship is healthy.
Gave you kids.
But still, kids is funny.
Bring
kids got
you out
great personality.
World,
but
like,
she want niggas like us to look at you, bitch. Are you serious? Hold on. Oh, what's going on?
Most niggas hard.
That's the vibe she gives,
though. He freaking her out. Like,
man, look, man.
But that's the vibe she gives out, though.
What? What vibe?
Like, wholesome?
Yeah, she does.
She give off Big Mama vibes, I mean, I'll be honest. Not like Big Mama, you cooking tonight? You know what I mean? That type shit. I ain't trying to hit on it.
Big Mama cooking and not.
Oh,
she
God.
Me, I think she cute,
but
you
she
feel
is,
me?
Yeah.
But she don't give me the over, like, she's super, like, bad. Like
I mean, she cover up.
But look, as a regular person,
not
how would y'all feel? How would y'all feel popping in, like, her DMs? Like, you would think about her husband first before you pop it. Like, first of all, I ain't gonna do that. Like, I would feel that thought. Like,
I would feel if I gotta hop in her DM, I gotta come like a recipe or something. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, look, I got these good titties, good crip legs. You know what I'm saying? Okay. Yeah, I mean, I got you.
Hey, like what Drake did, huh? Show up to
Drake
her.
Drake did, he went to the book signing and everything.
So you think Drake was trying to pop at her?
I don't know. Ooh, you feel me, Jay?
Come on now.
She wasn't complaining in.
She wasn't complaining in. Hey,
these women can't trust him, but I'm telling
you. Drizzy's slick, though. He might have tried to, like, on some, like, different shit. Like, yeah, I'm here as a friend, but what's up?
I think
if you with it, I'm with it. We
he just gave her a nod, like, smiling. No. Like, you wanna,
but bottom line is, she's proof of the pudding that women will never be satisfied.
I feel like her husband. It's just always, I feel like her husband just a little too. I fucks with him too. I fucks with Steph, but he probably just too squarish in the room. Like he gotta come on some gangster shit, slap her up and say, "Oh, what you want? You want this?
Come
you
in with a mask, like, right? Yeah, with a mask, come and kick the door down. Boom.
Yeah, like
smack her around. Boom, boom. Get on the floor. Get on
I'm
the floor.
I'm that C, baby. Don't call me Steph tonight, baby. I'm different tonight. You want some attention?
He said that.
I think she want his brother.
She wants the Seth.
Hey,
Seth, you know what? Hey, I blame the Smiths though. Every time niggas get that red table, niggas just start talking some shit.
Oh, facts, bro. Yes,
that red table is crazy,
but
man.
But Jordan, yeah, though, you can come talk that shit, baby. Come here. Blue table talk, baby. Hello, talk to the
blue
crib.
Table talk.
Gotta be some shit,
Jordan.
Though.
Hey, ever since that happened, I don't know what her PR people have been doing or whatever, but she been looking on fly. Looking dumb fly. Jordan.
Is that how you really feel?
Yeah, they touched her up a little bit. She look fire though. She bad. She been bad though.
She even more bad.
Nah, nigga, my eyes wasn't on her until that moment.
Because the focus is more was on her
now. She more bad now, bro. She like
flight. Put a baby in her flight.
She fly. Why is that
though? Or just like fuck with her flight.
But why is that though? How come because of this situation, like you, like, after that, you flight now. That's why I'm
Nah, it's not even that. You know when you know motherfuckers looking, you gotta step it up.
Yeah,
you know she on that. Like, they looking down.
Because she was who best friend at that point.
With the sweats on, baby.
She was Kim's best friend or Kylie's best friend. So she knew the focus wasn't all on her. Now the focus is all on her. So you're right. She now's like, oh, people really looking at me. Yo, let me get put my makeup on, make sure my weave right.
Let me go to the hottest place in Hollywood so TMZ can see me.
Yeah, that's true.
That shit be funny. Anytime somebody on TMZ, I'm like, okay, like, why'd you go there?
If
you
Aisha Curry, take notes. Take notes, baby.
But it ain't even about like revealing yourself. You just gotta look fly. Like, she be like covered up and she might as well wear a robe.
Hey, what did Jada Pinkett face look like when she said that?
She was agreeing with her.
She agreed with her.
Oh yeah, I know what you talking about. But you got the man that you want. You got a husband now, though. But,
really?
But at the same time, a lot of the women, they not feeling the way we feeling though. They understand where she come from. I don't understand where she coming from. She married. She got what? How many kids? Two kids? Three kids? How many kids she got?
Like,
y'all don't know?
Two or three kids.
So nobody, it should be as a sign of respect. Like, no dudes is popping at you in the DMs. Like, niggas respect your relationship. Like. And that's something rare, because niggas really don't give a fuck if you're in a relationship or not.
Like 20s? 30s?
Nah. Yeah, she's still young.
But girls, you know, you feel me? They do, like, imagine them going to the club, bro. They get ready, they get all prepped up so they can feel like they look good.
But that's not what she do.
But though, they would swear that they not trying to get niggas.
See, now you're about to go out some other shit. Yeah.
And that's a fact.
Bro. A girl walk in the club looking done the fuck up, like straight up and down a 10 plus, like nigga walk up, just like,
You know what you get mad at?
I was a damn
she
baby.
Give a nigga the stiff arm, like she ain't not here for that. But a club full of niggas.
Yeah, and I've tried that before too. Like, just I ain't trying to like,
got
pop at
her. You know,
but you had, I know you had some times where you try to pop at a chick. She like, hey, watch out.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh yeah, he lying like a motherfucker.
Hey, hey. Every guy in life has had that like
situation.
Nah, I be getting
stiff arm like a motherfucker. I remember back in Flay's days, bro. You remember Dante? Hey.
Dante, cash.
His ex girlfriend, Brittany from Carson. Yeah. Woo, she shot me down something crazy on his. Hey, look, they I was all going to other girls trying to get confirmation. Like, I'm pretty, huh, bitch? I'm a sex little motherfucker. This bitch is bad or something.
Hey, but that turned you into, like, you feel me? That's a change in your how you move. You feel me?
Hey, look,
girl, do that.
I can shit on all them hoes now. You know
what
I'm saying?
Yeah, fuck it. Shit on
you. Get it back up. You say, yo, what's up? You remember me?
Yeah, what's up? Pull it out on him. What's up?
Pull it out on him.
What you want? What you want? Where you trying to go?
Where you trying to go?
Pocket change.
Where you
want to
go?
We can go to Benihana's. It ain't even playing.
Benihana's.
Oh, excuse me. That's
Did high end.
I'm just like, I'll be going to
Barton G. What about Barton G? We go to Barton G.
Hey,
fuck
hey
it.
Baby. Hey,
y'all probably don't know about Barton G.
Fuck with me. You see up. Us now, baby.
Brittany, remember
this
me?
This same flag. This us.
That's how you know I'm a hood nigga. I'm talking about Benny Hannes.
Yeah, man. Benny
Hannes, hey, that, hey, Benny Hannes worked. Benny Hannes is like fireworks at Disneyland for some
hey,
girls.
For some,
bro.
For me, my that first time, I was like, oh, they cooking in girls. Front of me. Oh, shit.
Hey, look.
It's some high end shit.
No, look, I'm the same way. I'm, let me stop capping. I've never been to Benny Hannes before. Because I can't go to Benny Hannes, bro. Niggas gonna clown me like, oh, your broke ass ain't Benny Hannes.
Yeah, for real?
Bro, I put the bocce spot me and Slim is at. We got the whole spot to ourselves. I'm talking about we up there living lavish.
Yeah.
We putting the volcano up in there. Niggas like, oh, the same bocce tricks. I'm like, damn, bro, I can't enjoy the
shit. Enjoy my shit.
I said this in another podcast. If you post a picture of Jesus, they gonna say some foul shit.
You
follow what these niggas saying, bro. Sure. These niggas gonna, nigga, man.
Hey, man.
I ain't nearly got nobody in my comments like you, but niggas gonna say right is left and left is right, man. And you're like, that shit crazy. Niggas is wild.
Hey, this girl just put me on a new restaurant, though, Barton G.
Barton G.
Barton G. Yes, that shit fly. Like, you feel me?
You paid for it. She took you to Barton G and you paid.
Like, you got the bitch.
This is my restaurant I've never been to, but I want to go. Come take me. Like,
what's up?
Exactly. Come take me. No.
She did not say that to me.
Trick.
I ain't tricking on him. Nah. She was talking about this shit. I had looked up. I'm like, oh, this shit, nah, I ain't been yet, but you made me look nice.
Oh, so you going?
Yeah, I'm
when?
Going. Soon.
Soon.
You know,
reservations
tomorrow.
Already set. Shit. Just take a sip
of that. Drink your drink, my nigga. Drink your crack of Hennessy.
Niggas on me. I need
to drink. This nigga got a drop yes. Trying to drink something.
She said some shit. I ain't gonna even drink it.
Look, you told me.
You childish.
That nigga petty as hell.
Childish as
hell. Daddy is petty.
I am. So it's certain extent, nigga. What you mean?
I think everybody a little petty to a certain extent.
But look, so back to Aisha, bro. So what y'all think was the main like reason she said that shit?
Steph Curry.
Y'all think she really wants some side dick, or she just like?
Nah,
talking
I feel like she don't want no side dick, but Steph Curry is like.
I think she's slow.
Damn. Right. What you mean?
Why you think she's slow?
Yeah, you know, most light skinned women. You know, it's like
damn, little, just little.
They be too pretty. You know what I mean? They be a little off.
Hey,
too pretty.
I know what you're trying to say though. Like. They get pretty when they feel like they ain't getting that attention they used to. I can see that.
Yeah, because figure back when we was like in high school, whatever, like, y'all was like, '04, '05, my nigga.
Hold on, wait up. Damn, don't put something like that.
Shit,
nigga, I just graduated, nigga.
Yeah, we just graduated. What are you talking about?
What the fuck you talking about, nigga?
Look, I'm 19, but I'm just saying, like.
That's right.
But in that era, you feel me, like, girls, like, the way people looked at, like, light-skinned girls, don't make them act like that to me. You feel me? They got a certain stigma around them. Like, light-skinned girls is like this. Dark-skinned girls.
That's what I'm saying. Light-skinned girls are a little...
Yeah.
Is it our fault that we give them more attention, though?
Like, this is normal.
I don't give...
And she ain't getting that normality that she used to. Because niggas ain't popping.
It's a new day and age now. You feel me? Niggas is fucking with... You feel me? Like...
Looking, all type of flavors.
All type of flavors. That's everybody's shocking. Being promoted to be the best type of flavor. You feel me? Like, and it's funny though. The joke is really on the light skinned people now. You feel me? The joke is really on them.
Facts.
The joke is really on them now. It used to be nigga David Ruffin on them with the
nigga. All the light skinned niggas had all the bitches in high school, bro. They used to be clowning. Dark skinned niggas wasn't the ones. Now they're the ones, man.
Back in 06, 07, 08.
Hey, man bun still ain't in. I don't give a fuck with
that. You got the man bun.
Shut that shit up.
You got Edison all red and shit.
Hey, nobody give a fuck about looking insecure. That's how you down there in the gym, nigga. When they get insecure. Talk about my bun.
Fuck the bun, nigga.
Look at these guards, though.
I'm working out, nigga.
Talk about these guns,
huh? No, everything. Nah, man.
Look, skinny niggas ride. Don't give a fuck about niggas flexing.
But no, I just think, she feel a little... I don't insecure. Not insecure,
nah,
but...
Nah, she said she's insecure, bro.
It's just like... She just wants some outside attention. I don't know why she wants that attention, but...
How can she be insecure?
Well, she got millions of dollars for one.
Not even
you
have that.
So much security.
Nigga, you got millions of dollars because of your nigga.
Right?
I could have got this basketball contract bitch and stuck dick in another bitch.
Yeah,
I could have stuck dick in any bitch. I'm Steph Curry.
She wanted a dark skin tatted.
But how early was they together?
She wanted a dark skin.
So you gotta get tatted.
It don't matter.
Deep in high school.
Yeah, they've been fucking with each other for a long time.
Yeah, high school sweethearts.
She wants something different. She want a new feel. That's what it is.
Big Mama need to relax and go in that kitchen. We'll put some fucking yams.
Stop playing with yourself, girl.
Yeah, stop playing with yourself. Lose everything you got, Big Mama.
Nigga talking.
I'm thinking of the Martin Lawrence movie right now.
For real, Big Mama. Big Mama, don't listen to what these niggas talk about. Don't fuck up what you got going now, Big Mama.
I mean, I feel something.
How y'all think Steph felt about that shit?
I feel a little bit.
She ain't getting no
how would you feel about that shit?
Look, I'm going to stay in the guest house for a couple weeks. That's how I'm going in the doghouse, bitch. Like, I might want to go wild myself out now. Look,
I wonder how Steph Curry
I'll be
mad,
him
though.
Too, though. I'll be like,
I wonder what type of nigga he is to get mad, though.
I know. My personality, I'm mad, but bitch, my insecurity is fucked up. I'm fucking your fat ass. You want to do me like this?
On national TV? You think she told him before she told the
baby? Hell no!
You think she fat?
Bro, she definitely
BBW. I don't think she fat.
BBW?
Like
she not fat.
She's not fat.
She's like 150. That's not fat, though. Nigga, I can see 180. That's
how tall is she?
That's for a female?
Look, guy, look at me. This nigga like, what?
That's not fat. I'm skinny as fuck. I'm 155.
How tall are you? That little man.
I mean, it ain't hard to see. But then you're like, I got a bodysuit on or something. This nigga know I'm skinny.
This nigga's stupid.
How tall is she, though?
If she's short, if she like...
I don't know. I don't know how tall she is. But look, my...
Does she got a basketball profile?
She got a Mike. If she like 5'11, 5'10,
Mike's the fact of her being short, bro. I don't think
I mean, Steph Curry 6'3.
I don't think she told Steph though before she got a
if she did, if she didn't tell Steph.
And then he found out the way we all right, found
so
out.
Like, so you just gonna present it on the table, red table. And
how
you
was know. She? How was she?
Bro, they lying like a motherfucker. She ain't no 5'8", 120. That bitch built like a brick of cheese. She built like a brick of cheese. Look at that. He got that fucked up.
Oh.
She got a pretty face.
She
though.
Definitely.
She cute.
No, she's not cute, bro.
She cute, man.
She cute to me. She cute. She got some pretty eyes. She
pretty eyes. She cute. All that. Hey, Steph.
She like she got lips like she suck her thumb.
I'll pop that.
So you want to fight that?
Who, me?
Yeah. I would.
It's not something I go chase.
It's something that you gotta call your life.
You somewhere.
Bro, look at this.
She look cool.
Bro, look at this body.
Look, he going straight to that thing.
He ain't like that right now. I was like, he going straight to that thing.
She built like a 6-year-old boy.
Built like SpongeBob.
Hey, that's funny as fuck, man. Hey, but look, if he had said the same shit that she said,
oh, you know,
how you think she'll probably be
crying? She'll ask for a divorce.
You should be tripping up.
I asked for, actually, Steph,
that's that
divorce
double standard.
Steph, divorce, that's enough for you to get up out of this high and to pay no money. Get
I don't like the here. Double, even though the double standard is real, like, is real. It's something that we got to deal with. That shit is bullshit, because if he was to say the same shit, it'd be a whole big, or, oh, Steph ain't shit. The social media be going crazy. Like, this nigga ain't shit. He want side pussy. We got a great woman.
Just
like,
imagine him saying she don't cook enough.
But everybody in these comments, bro, is saying, oh, yeah, I feel where she coming from. Like, yeah, she's right. Like, women just want to be appreciated. And so
hey, but look, let me say this, because we got girl followers, too. Let me
we
say
do,
this.
And I'll fuck with all
let
y'all.
Let me say this, though. Guys and girls, I feel like, we don't never get each other. We all agree in something because we four guys. You feel me?
True.
My y'all probably sitting behind the camera not like agreeing with us right now.
She like,
you
no.
feel me? So like, it's just like a girl and guy. Like that's forever gonna be a conversation because we don't get each other fully. You feel me? Like some people might know more than others, but we don't get each other fully. You feel me?
That's true.
Like, it's just like that. That's how I feel like. I feel like I'll be getting a little serious. Everybody be like, okay, money. You said it, money.
Well, for all the female followers, we want to know what
majority
y'all
of our followers
think.
Is females,
they are,
bro.
They
that's
are,
what I'm
bro.
Saying.
They you are. Like, and we want to know. Like, comment. Let us know what y'all think. Like,
hey, look,
are we wrong? Or
I divorce y'all, too.
That part. We want to know what y'all think about this shit. Like, y'all, where y'all views at? Y'all agree with her or do y'all disagree with her?
Of course they agree with her.
Yeah, they are.
But they going to agree with her. I want to know a reason. Mayan, what was your reason to agree?
Because y'all looking at it as a like sexual standpoint.
No, so I'm looking at mental at? Too. I'm looking at mental too.
Like, I'm insecure about my body. I want some attention from her husband.
No.
Did she say she didn't have sex?
No, she said for men.
She didn't say for men.
She didn't say from her husband.
She didn't say from her husband. She said for men. Exactly.
But how are we supposed to know,
chew that gum. Chew that gum.
No, but that's I feel like that's why she's saying what she like. People are saying what she's saying because she didn't say from Steph. But I don't know because she was an interview. Because you know they painted.
She probably meant
she probably got nervous and said from men, but she probably meant to say from her husband.
Y'all seen what Jada said after that? She like, girl, I felt the same way back in the day. We'll call it. Hey.
We still feeling that way? What's up?
What's up?
But they have an open relationship though.
Desirable, right?
That's what they say. Yeah, everybody want to be desirable.
You, but if you, to me, but to
male attention.
But to me,
there's nothing wrong with that.
If you marry,
you're not married. Justify.
Yeah, I think because look, every woman,
they're married.
Main majority of women
got each other back. That's what's so late. That's like fuck with the legit gay pride community. How do you pronounce that shit?
LGBT.
Legit gay pride.
What that shit mean?
LGBT.
What is it? What is that? I gotta look that
lesbian,
shit up.
Lesbian, bi.
It don't even matter. It's gonna
I
be posted on
legit gay pride.
That's what I'm gonna call it now.
Yeah, legit gay. Whatever it is.
Hey, but the viewer, especially the females, please comment under and let us know.
Let us know.
Like,
let us know.
Yo, justification for the reason you would say that. Because if you gonna say men.
Yeah, just don't say we agree with Aisha or A. Curry. Like, Mrs. Curry. Let us know why y'all
A. Curry.
Agree.
Niggas gave her a slang name. A. Curry.
A. Curry.
Hey, that might,
a.
That
Curry.
That might give her a little edge.
Yeah, well, niggas might pop their DM after that. Like, I like her name. What up,
hey, Curry?
Hey, Big Mama.
Big Mama. Big Mama Curry.
Hey, but y'all let us know.
I got convicted. But now I'm back, dog, and it's back. Back to business. Niggas tough in they raps, but really snitch. Really, I put my hood on the map, I'm really in it. I bought my little dog a strap, he really trippin'. He heard you got them packs, now he on the mission. EBK shit, anybody get it. Now we on. No, I don't politic, I'm no politician.
Okay. So I read somewhere, matter of fact, you made a song called Louis Farrakhan.
Yeah.
Louis Farrakhan got banned from social media. What you think about that shit?
Like all social media platforms.
I think anything with a threat to bring people out by the masses and to convey a message by the masses and it be interpreted by the masses at that very moment for somebody from that powerful of a stature, that's not, you know, a government entity. I think it's a danger.
Yeah, especially when you black too.
Exactly. So
you gotta add that to
I think that's basically what it is. I mean, it's just like, it's a threat to society. That's how they feel. And that just solidifies it a lot more that happened. I'm happy that happened. That lets everybody know that he's on the right track. Yeah, like, he actually knows what he's doing. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So, that should make people pay attention a lot more. You know what I mean?
I think it is going to make people pay attention.
And on top of that, too, the nigga's moving militant. You feel me? Nigga just talking and out in the streets not moving right. The nigga moving like the president.
When Nipsey passed, bro, I went to the Marathon clothing store. And I feel like one of the main reasons that it was so peaceful and wasn't no violence, bro, because Nation of Islam was there making sure shit was going accordingly. You feel me? They was out there like the military, bro, like making sure everything is good, ain't no nonsense. They out there with newspaper, they out there with they suits, they tie, they lined up a certain way, making sure people come in, they doing crowd control, making sure the crowd's not bro. It was like, you feel me, it was like, okay, who are these? If you don't know who the Nation of Islam was, you like, who are these people? Like, and it makes you kind of dig deeper into learning about who the Nation of Islam was and who's leading these people. And when you come to Louis Farrakhan teaching, you understand like, oh damn, this is deep as fuck. And they don't want to hear none of this shit we're talking about, bro. They don't, nothing positive in black people upliftment and this movement that Farrakhan was on, bro. They don't want us to do that shit. You feel me? It's too powerful. We too powerful when we come together on the intellectual level. They rather have us out here gang banging, shooting niggas up and shit. But something like this, bro, where we really leveled up to the same like status as the government and the same status as the U.S. You feel me? They like, oh, this is a threat. Maybe we can get ran out of this motherfucker. And they don't want none of that shit, bro.
I mean, don't want that. Like, even like as far as like the weed, the marijuana industry, right? Mm-hmm. The reason I feel like I know they ain't making it legal because like the heads of marijuana, they all minorities. Like Cookies, you got Burner, you got Wiz Khalifa, Snoop. All these people minorities, and the marijuana industry is a $1 billion industry. So boom, them cutting that in. That's why they got the people in suits trying to pull up to niggas like, yo, I want in on your company. I want in on your business. You feel me? Because once they go and make it legal, these niggas gonna be making stupid bread. Snoop, Wiz, Burner, B Real, all them niggas gonna be making like dumb
niggas,
bread. Like, you feel me? Because you said what?
Even the street hustler that's throwing up the like the same doing the same shit.
Nah, street. Whoever got a name and brand on their shit, like Burner, B Real, Wiz Khalifa, like Snoop, you feel me? They gonna be the ones to be making bread. You feel me? Even Nipsey, if the Marathon OG's still out, you feel me? Game got some shit. So, you feel me? You got some Cutthroat OG?
Not yet.
I know you got some stuff in the works too. You feel me? So, and I know it's the interview, but I want to say this too. Like this man right here, y'all, people need to pay more close attention to.
Yeah.
Pay a whole lot more close attention to, because this man right here is the owner of his. He signed himself. I say that every time because we just say that ourselves. This nigga signed himself, my nigga.
Oh, God.
I ain't gonna yell that for just me. This is a black young man who just signed himself. You feel me? Like,
exactly.
Y'all need to pay more attention. You feel me? You got his own clothing line. You feel me? Y'all don't want to fuck with. Y'all want to fuck with Gucci.
Congrats on everything.
But if y'all want to fuck with Gucci, they got some fly shit that then you feel me, black owned, you feel me, like
go support it.
Yeah, go support that shit, man. Like, so, because it's
the
right
black
here.
Excellence.
Don't like, wait, don't wait till something happens to a motherfucker to. Oh, let me
go pay attention.
Like,
to
like
him,
you already
like,
know, like
yeah, yeah,
don't do that. You feel me? That's good too to uplift a name, but don't do that.
And we see that a lot, bro. It's in social media and everyday talk. Like, yeah, I want to support people that's doing some shit, but it's just talk and there's no action behind the shit.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I be getting annoyed by. Like, damn, bro, you speak all this black excellence and shit. You say you looking for somebody to support that's doing their own shit. But at the end of the day, it's so many people like Joey, like us, that's doing some shit. You feel me? Where people could support at the time, but it's like, okay. Where the support at? You just talking at the end of the day.
No, nah, I'm sure it's like, people that support you, but I'm talking about
it
like,
is. But I'm just talking about as a whole,
for
like
people like him. You feel me?
Yeah.
But honestly, you should be catastrophic to the head. To where you
because as you can see, the people in charge, they don't give a fuck about it. They just banned Louis Farrakhan from social media. We have a right to freedom of speech, and they just banned him from.
You got a right to freedom of speech.
You feel me? Like
you got a right to freedom of speech if it ain't.
Talking against everybody
that ever said some shit that may plant a seed in your head to do better in your life, bro.
Yeah, that's real shit.
One thing that I could say that bothers me just about, like, not even just Farrakhan, just any black person that's talking about or trying to uplift another black person, they always start talking about, like, the white man or something like that. You can't talk about racism when you've been racist yourself. You know what I mean? Basing our conversation about a white man. Like let's just talk about us.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because that's what make niggas seem ignorant. Mm-hmm. That's what gets him banned and stuff like that because they call it hatred now. You get what I'm saying?
The hatred spree.
That's only how they got him.
So you're talking about like his approach to
it. That's only how he got him because of his approach. You know what I mean? Because it's the white man. They think think he racist. You know what I mean? But you know how he's a lot older school than us. You know what I mean? His parents was probably, you know, slaves.
Why they ain't banned fucking Trump? He be talking all type of hate speech and shit.
He got a different type of money, bro. Because
he grabbed him by the pussy.
He
don't need nobody's support.
Yeah. All his people went to jail. He ain't even go to jail. out, nigga.
Bro,
wow.
Ain't paid taxes in 10 years.
Nigga,
$1 billion in losses, bro.
Nigga, a real Teflon Don.
Yeah. Teflon Don.
Trump is a Teflon Don.
And he don't give a fuck. He don't let you know exactly what it is. Shit, so we gave you that inspiration to do that song, bro. Louis Farrakhan, that Farrakhan song.
Yeah. I've been practicing Islam for a minute.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
It's Ramadan right now, you know what I mean? I've been practicing Islam for a couple of years now. I'm not somebody who's just going to say I'm Muslim.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Because it's a lot to learn. You know, you got to know your numerical code, especially when you're talking about the Nation of Islam. You know, when it comes to, like, East Coast, you got, like, the 5%ers. They be like, what's the math, God?
Yeah.
Even though, like, that's, like holistic, you know what I mean? I still want to know, you know what I mean? Like, what got them to that point, you know what I mean? What got Farrakhan to that point? What got Malcolm X to the point to where he rebelled, you know what I mean? It's like, it's a lot of things I want to take into account before I dedicate myself to something. So I've been studying it for years, you know what I mean? I got mentors, you know, I go to mosque.
That's dope.
You know, a lot of stuff. You know what I mean?
That's dope. That's like my homie. Free my nigga Randy. Yeah. I'm going to say that.
Free
my nigga Randy.
It's just the code of conduct that Islam go by that I fuck with.
Yeah.
It's teaching you to stay disciplined. You know what I mean? You know, Ramadan, you know, you salat, you know what I mean? 7 times a day. So you get peace. You go unplug. Don't be on your phone for like 15 minutes and just chill. If you try to do it 7 times a day, I guarantee you your day going to be a lot easier.
Yeah.
You won't be mad or nothing like that. It's just they teachings. You know, don't eat pork and shit like that. That shit. They put you on something, you know what I mean? Try not to.
No, my family was, I grew up Muslim, bro. Like, my family, I've never had pork in my life, but my family grew up Muslim. My grandpa, rest in peace, he was a part of the Nation of Islam for years. You feel me? So he was kind of like the catalyst to the family and kind of led and spearhead that Nation of Islam teachings to us. So I don't practice as much as I should, or I don't, you feel me? I got to get back into it. I've been slacking a lot. But it does come with a discipline. You gotta be real.
I'm that nigga that's gonna fast in Ramadan and still go to church on Sunday.
Yeah.
It's not even the fact. I just believe in, like, people get caught up in how people are trying to convey the message, rather than the overall message being about God.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Now, I just believe in God. I don't care if you're Christian, Catholic. I'm gonna go praise God to my belief in your church. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's
like,
as well.
And you know what I mean? Niggas might call me whatever they might call me, but I fuck with y'all, but I believe in God.
That's yeah, it. That part, man. Everybody trying to put these titles and try to box you in on one title. I think Eddie Griffin says some real shit, bro. He's like, Christians that got a message, they got a person that brings you the message. Islam, they had a person that bring you the message. Buddhism, they have a person that bring you the message. It don't matter who brought the message. Yeah, nigga, did you get the message? Like, you feel me? And that's some real shit. Yeah. I'm like, yeah, you can't just box somebody in on. I know me personally, when it's come to like certain boxes and boxing me in, that's why I feel like, oh, hold on, like, that's not just me, bro. I believe in this, but I'm not like just closed minded, so I'm not gonna listen to what the fuck you gotta say. And I think a lot of people, they kind of get closed into the box and like, oh no, if it's not part of my group, then I'm not gonna listen to nothing you saying. Like, but that's ignorance, bro. You ain't gonna be able to grow like that. It's just no growth.
I feel like
certain people set
the guidelines to certain like religions, Christianity, because it'd be like so strict. Like, if you're not this, you're not going to heaven. You feel me? It's like some brainwash shit. But I ain't really read everything on like a every situation. You feel me? Mm-hmm. I ain't really read none of that. You feel me? So I just believe in like
no, it's all the same stuff.
Yeah, it's like the same kind of thing. Muslims, it's like some little
Islam Muslims. They just believe Muhammad came and conveyed the message after you know Jesus, you know, to finish it off. You know what I mean? Or after God to finish it off. It's just the Quran is from Muhammad's perspective. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I said it's the same shit.
Yeah, that's why I feel like it's God's.
It's all
like
the same
with
it's
thing.
Prophets.
Like,
it's all prophets. It's prophets. Speaking about from what they experience with God, bro.
Yeah.
It's one God to me.
It's just like how Nipsey can write a Bible right now. Just how everybody like, Nipsey's a prophet.
Yeah.
Right. And everybody can follow by them guidelines. It's the same
for sure. For sure, they would.
That's real shit. And that's just to say, don't get caught into
in the
title.
Books. Nigga, get caught up in God.
Yeah,
there,
like so if you believe in a higher power, bro, and believe in God, then that's all that matters.
Yeah, but Farrakhan, he that guy. He's super dope, bro.
Yeah. Farrakhan, that dude, man. We ain't even banning Farrakhan because we speaking about him right now.
Right now. You feel me? So look him up. Look up his teachers. Look up his YouTubes. All that.
I gotta look up the teacher where you talk about McDonald's and how you killing motherfuckers.
McDonald's is not real food. Do not eat McDonald's. Y'all niggas is eating plastic.
Hey, you know what's weird, bro? I feel like I don't fuck with McDonald's when it comes to like lunch and dinner, but they breakfast, I feel like it's different.
That shit, nigga, you eating plastic
happy
flapjacks, nigga.
It's Happy Meal with me. I feel like the breakfast is a little better than everything else.
Eat
like,
a fork.
Y'all know,
eat a fork.
Y'all know, Denny's and IHOP, they keep fake eggs unless you ask for it.
Is it fake eggs?
I don't even eat breakfast. This nigga be
this
dude's
man, right?
You gotta ask him to give you actual eggs. Like, and that's
niggas eating rubber.
Damn, but they be having white
eggs. That's why all the man, it's
made perfect.
Is it powder?
Yeah, it's powder.
The powder?
Powder.
That's crazy. Remember I asked you?
What's in the powder?
It just like makes it yellow, I guess. I've seen
clone
it before.
Egg meat, nigga.
Yeah,
I don't know.
It's fake eggs, nigga. Hey, some clone egg meat. You gotta ask them, niggas, be like, nah, I want real eggs. Nah.
See, right? That's why y'all niggas always teasing me about the nachos.
Fun
like,
facts from Joey
that's
Facts.
Why I get, that's
nigga.
Why I get tacos and nachos,
fun
nigga,
facts.
From Denny's, nigga.
Still I'm not.
Huh? Shit, it's tortilla chips, jalapenos, and cheese. Ain't nothing can be fake about that shit. Y'all niggas eating rubber and plastic.
Hey, I didn't know that, though. I didn't know Denny's was serving fucking
fake. Remember, I was asking that. I was like, is this real?
Yeah, we just had Denny's a couple nights ago. Yeah. 2 nights ago.
Eating rubber eggs.
Rubber eggs.
Damn.
Fun right. Facts from Joey Fats. You have to ask for real
I'll
eggs.
That anyways.
My brother will... My big brother name is Jody, and I always, you know, follow behind him. Yeah. He wasn't around when I was with Brees and him. He was in jail for a long time. He got out, like, my senior year. His name is Jody, and his name is Big Fats. My name is Joey, and my name is Lil Fats from the... So, Joey.
Salute to Big Fats.
Mushed it in. Mm-hmm. I thought it was because you was like a young fat boy when you was like, Joey, you fat.
I had to rub you up when I was 90. That's how big I was.
Like husky, nigga.
I was like 220, nigga.
Damn. You was a husky,
little
young
now
boy.
Compared to how I was.
Damn, that's crazy, bro. I ain't never touched twos.
The closest that guy was like 180.
180, yeah.
Oh, you really lighting the ass.
That's lighting the ass.
Damn. That's what the big mama was saying. You lighting the ass.
Lighting the ass.
It's like a mom grandma came up right now.
You lighting the ass.
Hey.
You really like that ass, nigga.
Nigga, I'm a skinny nigga. RIP Prospect. Skinny nigga still ride with
the city. That's crazy. Prospect.
For real. RIP.
Yeah. Y'all quiet with that one, huh?
Stupid. Hey, but speaking of this.
We ain't gonna talk about Class 5 now.
Class 5. Nigga, first we gonna say Good of the Woods. Shout out DJ Steve, my nigga. You even gave us that name.
DJ Steve.
Hey, nah, free my nigga Pac Slim. He the reason I even made music in the first place. Nigga came back with a string. I said, ooh.
The string mic.
Niggas had a tape to a wall.
Tape to that wall right there. Like, what are you talking about? Like, really?
Hey, you remember that song? Stunner Glasses?
Stunner Glasses.
Niggas all got on that song.
Bro, that shit was B-Man. Shout out to B-Man, bro. Everybody else probably don't know who the fuck I'm talking about, but yes.
Niggas know what I'm talking about.
Right now,
people watching this.
But look, man, speaking of the city, bro. Speaking of the city, and I know we just had a little convo about Nip, bro. I think if Snoop was doing the same shit that Nipsey was doing, would he still be alive today?
If Snoop would have been around in the hood, I'd just say, or not in the hood, but like sticking around in Long Beach, like people wanted him to, I feel like he would not be here right now. That's my opinion. People try to trick you out.
He would have even been dead or shot up by now. So People try
to trick you out your position. Oh, he don't want to come around here no more. He ain't real. He ain't.
It'd have been,
and you go around
like
there, and
the same shit.
Nigga that's gonna do some shit to you, wanna rob you and all that shit.
Besides, that same mind state is what's gonna keep your neighborhood impoverished.
I'm not saying don't.
Nah, that's real.
Stand on what you believe, bro.
Stand on what you believe, but you ain't gotta let niggas trick you out of your position.
No, man, nah, nigga ain't gonna trick you out. That's why you built. You see what Farrakhan did? You know that nigga houses in the hood in Chicago? You build the people around you.
But fair time.
That's some real shit.
You build the people around
you. Your wall can only be so thick to people behind it.
Bro,
like,
if
it's
somebody would have had a gun at that store, he'd have been all right.
That's a fact. But as far as Snoop doing somewhere that people like, being in Long Beach, like how you want people want you to, stand outside in that parking lot of VIP,
same shit
would happen.
Unless you move in the way you need to move, you said, unless you like really get like
just move the right way. Yeah, that's all you gotta do.
Militant, like you see, nobody touched Farrakhan. He ain't been touched.
Farrakhan is not an active gangbanger from nowhere.
He ain't been touched though, but he listen to what the fuck he talking about.
But you gotta
about.
Think about it though.
It's more
about.
Than a gangbanger shit.
Snoop was coming up. It was the most peace in Long Beach though. It was the most peace.
I can't speak on that. I wasn't in Long
Beach. The Insanes in '20s wasn't beefing. Nobody was really beefing back then. Nobody wasn't beefing back then.
But throughout that whole time. You remember that song?
Throughout that whole time.
You remember that song? Bato, you don't believe what I saw.
That's different though, bro.
That was still during the time. It don't matter how long it was though.
I'm talking about that's different. If you would have made a song talking about Bato, the Mexicans would have got on you back then.
No. That wasn't about the Mexicans.
What you talking about?
That was about the rival gang members. You feel me? 20s rivals.
Nah, the Vato
listen
song.
I'm just talking about
the problems he had from that.
Yeah.
There was a lot of Mexicans on him about that from taking the Hispanic culture.
Juice was on the song.
That don't matter.
As far as this city,
on the verses,
he was spinning. He said niggas trying to act, talk about they want my chain and they gonna leave with it. But look, they don't know. Once they get close, that's three motherfuckers laid dead on the floor.
Yeah.
Nah, I'll listen to the words motherfuckers say. He ain't come out put that energy out because nigga he just felt like that out the blue. Nigga, it was some chatter in Long Beach. Oh, niggas is on you. They say. Niggas would have, man, I already know what would happen. Snoop is actually smart, but I feel like he could have.
But even with him not even being in Long Beach, it was some static. Like a couple years ago, people were saying some shit like, he don't do nothing for Long Beach. Yeah. He give some shit.
You can't
he
help
come back to the hood.
You can't help everybody, bro.
To help anybody, you got to preserve yourself at the same time. Because if you gone, you're not really doing no justice to nobody. So
yeah,
I'm not saying.
Him?
You said what?
That one, what's that one YouTuber girl?
Man, I ain't speaking about that.
I'm just saying. Fuck what she talking about.
I'm talking about the other way. I have like no point to talk about that.
But nah, man, I feel like if Snoop stayed in Long Beach and he was doing the same shit that Nipsey was doing, bro, I don't know if he'll be like dead right now, but I know it'd be some shit where he had to oversee.
Long Beach would be in a better place.
It'd
period,
be different,
point
bro.
Yeah, I feel that.
Long Beach would be in a better
place. It'd be more
definitely,
like
definitely. No matter what
unity,
cause,
for show. It'd be more unity.
Man, I stop being bitches, bro. That's my bad. If I gotta die out here to change the culture in the way motherfuckers, then you gotta think about it, bro. I could have been walking away from the hood and been rich a long time ago.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
bro, but I refuse to leave niggas behind, bro.
Yeah.
Point blank. If it costs you a life, bro, you gotta stop being a bitch, bro. We here to change the tide. It's a lot of freedom riders, it's a lot of people. Fucking Bungie Carter who died behind this shit, bro. We're trying to change the way y'all think. The main reason you think radical because of people like Bungie Carter and the Black Panther Party.
And they
stop being bitches out there, bro.
They smack the nigga down.
So stop being bitches, bro. You gotta talk about over
nigga.
Stand on what you believe, bro.
Stand on what you believe. Nigga, my whole point of view.
Bro, Nipsey would die talking shit, fool. He didn't die being a bitch.
Nipsey would never die being a bitch.
Died talking the shit that he was talking the whole time he was living.
Yeah, but niggas would try to, niggas will subconsciously try to trick you out your position. I'm saying that now. Niggas will try to trick you out your position and make you not here. You're vamoose now. Mm-hmm. You're done now, nigga. You're done.
Wait, what you mean by trick you out your position?
Like, niggas will trick you out your position. You being Snoop Dogg, you being from a certain gang or whatever, you feel me? You definitely got enemies. You definitely got people from your set that's not even fucking with you. Like just
that's true.
Niggas really not fucking with you. Niggas might be smiling in your face, but they not fucking with you really, you feel me? Like, so niggas would be like, oh well, he can't come around no more to make you feel like you gotta come around. Then you come around, them niggas be the same niggas that take your shit, nigga.
Shit.
Don't give a fuck about nothing you got going on, your family, your kids, no nothing. Like I'm not saying like his shit didn't do no business in the city, me? Like, but just like
stay away.
He should have definitely kept VIP open, but that's another story. But Just be smart. You feel me?
Be smart.
Like,
wait,
don't let
that
nigga
move.
Tell you like, what you can't. You can't. Oh, he can't come here. Nigga, I'll pull up 10 armor stick. Nigga, what's up?
We in forest back to back. These bitches loving that. All I do is give a wood like a lumberjack. I ain't good at conversating. I don't text it back. Cause I don't want relations, baby. I just want that cat. I feel like Lex Luger, all these fucking racks. You moving slimy, thump or shoot you, so watch how you act. Say she like I maneuver when I'm on the yell. Call me suit you, how I do it, gotta come in fast. I've been kicking back, now I'm on the ass. I've been taking breaks, now I'm on the gas. I gotta make it shake, I gotta get it back. Dog, I gotta make a way, I gotta be the man. Spent a little time away, I had to make a plan to make sure my niggas straight, my
taste the sugar shit.
Yeah, he was definitely a
champion. I was about to.
We're gonna get on this next segment, my man Joey interview. And I know you're dropping a project soon. What's that called?
Chipper Jones 4, man.
Chipper Jones 4. It's a series.
Hey, in a week.
Number 4.
In a week. So today the 9th. So a week from the 9th.
This is my 7th mixtape.
7, okay. You've been working.
7th.
What can the people expect from this one, bro?
A lot of bangers. A lot of fun.
Did you make any beats on this one?
Nah.
Okay, he acting like Kanye right now.
Nah.
This one. It's gonna be a surprise one. Somebody else shit.
Why you didn't make none of the beats? Your beats be slapping, bro.
I just got back making beats. Okay. I be taking breaks so I can analyze a lot of shit. That's how I learn. If you're just constantly making beats, you don't take the time to listen to nothing.
Sure.
These niggas is talented out here. I be listening to what they be doing, a little sauce.
So you look at the landscape.
A little sauce of the shit.
When you say listen, you look at like the landscape, everything that's going on. That's why, okay.
Where music at? Because, I make more like hip hop, like beats, like samples.
Yeah.
So when I just listen to other shit, like I listen to Gunna, I listen to all that stuff, and you learn how to put that bounce up in there, you know what I mean? You put that boom up in there, you know what I mean? That drip, you know what I mean? You know how they be saying,
that drip.
The drip.
Do you feel like it's easier to create from like some shit that you created or like some that somebody else sent you?
It's harder for me to rap on my own beats.
Yeah.
Really? Because you feel like you put some more time into it.
I don't even make beats, but I always thought that. For sure, I always thought it'd be
like
harder.
It's like a story.
It's like
a story. You know what I mean? You hear where the story starts from, so you want to finish it the right way.
Yeah.
I don't even know
how you mind fucked up.
That's what I was saying. Fuck
I would be like, I'll be sitting there like, what the fuck?
On everything.
It's sort of like even when I just write rhymes, you know what I mean? Not even write rhymes, but when I be rapping and shit. Like, it's hard for me to go from, like, say, for instance, like, standing in my car, to jump to a whole different topic. Me being such a storyteller, I gotta say what happened to get me out the car.
It's
hard for me to write like actual hit songs because of that. Because I be like, man, you're not making sense. I be telling a lot of niggas, they be jumping from topic to topic.
That's a real key point you just said, because a lot of people, that's what's the difference between people that's talking about something to people that's not talking about shit. If you go from topic to, I smoke weed, I do this, I do this, I sit land,
Like what happened in between all that?
Okay, how did you get from this to that? Damn.
Bro, and that's what be fucking with me. That's why
when I know you like, yeah.
When y'all be trying to put me on these new niggas, bro, I be like, that shit weak, bro. Cause I be in too much of my mind. Like, okay, man, you was doing this. How the fuck did you get from here to there? Like, what happened in the middle, bro? And I be too much in my mind, bro. That's asking all questions.
But I mean, you just gotta take shit, cause shit is surface level now. Like, you just surface level.
It is, bro, but still, like,
I blame people like Lil Wayne for that.
For what?
Just like, you feel me, I smoke weed, I do this, I sip lean, I sip drink, I do this, like, just fast paced type shit that's saying what it is, you feel me. Lil Wayne said that, but he would kind of tie it in, but he would just be more so like
bars,
you feel me, like just give it to you how it is, you feel me. You niggas take that shit and
that's it. So you say this project is like more like storytelling, or what is it?
First of all, it's been a storytelling since Tripper Jones 1.
It's not like, it's not so personal, I would say that. Okay. It's not so personal in the music, but you can hear from the subject matter. You're like, okay, it's something that's going on, but I'm not telling the story. Like, it's a couple songs where I make myself vulnerable and start talking about my family and my aspirations, but to close out the Tripper Jones series, because I don't plan on doing another one.
So that's the last Tripper Jones?
I just feel like, y'all know who I am already.
Yeah.
Take these and get on, you know what I mean? And it's just all bangers, you know what I mean? It's just, it ain't no, the outro is the only one that's gonna have you just like, okay, it's somber, because you start talking about, like, cause it's that being the last song you're gonna hear out of all the Tripper Jones series. Yeah, I just wanted them to know, like,
put the bow on the press,
this is where I'm at now, you know what I mean? I got a daughter, you know what I mean? The rap shit is dope, but I'm a businessman, like, I'm getting checks from Sprite now. You know what I mean?
So it's crazy. Okay.
Stun on the people
from
real quick.
Right now, from Tripper Jones 4,
say what you say.
What would you tell Tripper Jones 1, Joey?
Slow down, bro. Don't crash and burn out here for them. Save your money.
But that does that trip you out? Like, just like, do you ever think about, like, Tripper 1? Like, just because it's a
did
city,
I ever
like,
think I will be over here from a standpoint to where I'll be secure, safe, have my own house, have my own car, have my own money? Nah, when I come over, I was homeless. You know what I mean?
I was in the garage with you at Tripper Jones 1.
You know what I mean? I didn't see myself there, but at the same time, I believed it, because I remember when I worked at Tilly's, you know what I mean? I used to tell people I wrote Gucci Gucci for Krayshawn. And I didn't, but it just was like, I wanted something. You know what I mean? I could tell I wanted something. So, like, you know, it happened in the right way, but, you know, the young Joe, it's just slow down, bro. You know what I mean? Save your money. I spent over $1 million in this shit just trying to help people.
You know what just mean? Trying to help somebody, man.
Help rappers, you know what I mean? Try to help make people a part of what I'm doing. You know what I mean? Just believe in yourself, too. I just now believe in it.
You sure know how to pick them, though. You feel me? From, I ain't gonna name the name, but you like,
the resume.
The resume that you, people you picked to be on Cutthroat, they was the right picks. You know? So you definitely got, you on some Birdman level type shit. You feel me? So that's why I need people to understand what's going on, what you see in front of you right now, and what he doing with music.
We on some environmental shit lately though. I don't really speak much, I don't even talk to my manager about all that shit. But like, I mean, the music shit is dope and stuff like that, but I'm really on some community shit. Not even on some community shit, like on some outreach and be on the corner selling t-shirts. Nah, I'm like on some, like, I'm like the tech side of things. Like, how can I make it easy on people on that side? You know what I mean? I'm trying to get in that life. So, like, that's the type of shit I'm on now. You know what I mean? The music shit is cool. It's dope. You know, I ain't did music since, like, a couple months now. Like, probably a month or two. Because I've been done. Like, I got a whole nother album dropping after Tripper Jones 4 with Jameson. Like, it's complete. Like, I got, like, three whole albums done already.
You been working, people.
So it's like you playing it all out so you can relax.
No cap. No, I even, you know, my new management, you know, I put everything's in place. Like, I did everything myself, filled everybody out. You know what I mean? I seen, you know, put him in position, you know what I mean? And everybody just, everything's working out, you know what I mean? Like, where I lack at, he's strong, you know what I mean? And that's pretty much all I need. Like, I don't need a team, because I'm a person that like to work. I don't need you doing this, I don't need you doing that, because I don't want to go do it. I have nothing to do. I got depression, all type of issues. Let me go outside. I don't need to be at home. That's why niggas be killing themselves, bro.
Because
they be depression and just be at home, just sitting there, you dig what I'm saying? Like, get outside.
Depressed and shit,
you know what I mean? So, like, I want to do it.
Just want to be out in the world, just standing
there. But, you know what I mean? Like, just back to just. Shit, just tell Young Joy, bro, you can do it, bro. Like, bro, honestly, just the business side of shit, like, you gotta think bigger than the rap, bro. That's what got me into this position, because I seen the bigger picture. It wasn't just about Joey rapping. It's about
something
making a moment, That's what I've always been about. That's what people don't realize. I'm about making moments. Mm-hmm. And I'm the nigga that brought the money back to Long Beach, regardless what anybody said.
Brought the money back to Long Beach. You are correct, Amundo. You are correct, Amundo.
So do you feel like the loyalty is reciprocated? Like, it's the same loyalty and dedication that you had? Do you feel like that same loyalty is, like, giving back to you?
Nah, but it don't matter. I don't look for accolades.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like I said, I'm ready to die for what I believe in. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, you can't get pat on the back when you're in a casket anyway. You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah,
who you do it for? Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. So it's just like, it don't matter at the end of the day, bro. You know what I mean? I'm a people pleaser, no homo. You know what I mean? As long as I see motherfuckers smiling, bro, regardless of how you smile, my nigga, I see I did something for you. Some people don't know how to, you know, convey feelings, you know what I mean, to where, you know, you never know what's going on with a motherfucker, you know what I mean? So I don't look for shit in return, bro. Like, it's a lot of shit I did for rap niggas that ain't got shit back. You know what I mean? The love is really in family, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Niggas you grew up with, niggas who know you, I would tell you that, you know what I mean? Like, that's where you go see the most reciprocated loyalty and love.
Mm-hmm. From the people, and that part, bro, a lot of people don't understand, because I feel like, as far as, like, especially Long Beach, bro, like, I feel like Long Beach is not a city where we can come together and help each other out. You feel me? And
Long Beach ain't seen nothing.
It's not like, but it's a lot of talented people out here in Long Beach that could be coming together and, like, really build the city up as far as, like, the hip-hop culture, rap culture, and all that. But I feel like a lot of people be out here looking out for themselves. You feel me? And as far as you coming up here and coming to the podcast and, you know, always being real and always, you know, showing love and shit, that's something that people should follow. And that's something that people will follow. I feel like it just needs somebody to take that first step. You feel me? Because a lot of people got, it's a lot of hate in Long Beach, bro. Whether y'all see it or not, it is a lot of like outside hate where they're not gonna tell you directly they ain't fucking with you, but they do some shit, subtle shit. We're like, no, I just ain't fucking with you. Like, you feel me? And I feel like that shit is something that something need to be changed, bro. Niggas need to break that cycle, and I feel like you, somebody that's breaking that cycle.
Well, you gotta think about it, bro. You gotta think about it, like. First of all, the most successful people is selfish.
Yeah.
You gotta be selfish, first of all.
Yes, yeah.
And number two, I mean, coming up, I never seen a Phantom, a Wraith, none of that stuff until I left Long Beach.
Yeah.
You don't see that type of shit out here.
You don't.
So,
you don't.
For anybody to be rapping, saying all this and believing this, you know, it's like a far-fetched pipe-ass dream out here.
It is, for real.
You know what I mean? To where, like, how can you expect somebody to believe in what you're doing when he never seen it before?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. So it's just like, just another nigga blowing smoke.
Bro. Yeah,
exactly. I was just telling my cameraman, so you can't, shit like that.
You can't be mad at a nigga for not believing because he ain't seen the shit.
You
know what I mean? Like, if he see it himself and he don't believe, then he can say, nigga, you stupid. Bro. Yeah. You hate ass nigga.
I've seen this shit. Like,
but nigga been private soul dreams his whole fucking life, nigga. Like, I'm tired of this nigga. Where the Wraith at?
Where the money? Where the Wraith? Nigga, what's up? Nigga, show us something different. Like,
eyes, nigga.
Off top.
I don't think it's just, bro, but at the end of the day, bro, like, niggas is gonna support anything that's making progress.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of niggas just rapping nowadays and ain't making no progress. Mm-hmm. It don't matter what you rapping about, but if you go from being that nigga in the bucket, then you got a Honda. Then you got a little C300. Then you gotta be off rap.
Yeah, yeah.
It can be off you just working. You can be a longshoreman.
Yeah.
Then you go from the Mercedes to, shit, did he just get a GTR or something?
Maybe this shit is real. Let me start going.
They gonna gravitate towards anything make progression. You can't just be this nigga rapping about all this lavish stuff with this progression, and we gonna do this, we gonna do that. And
you
nigga,
you for the shit.
Living in the apartments up the street.
Right. Nigga seeing you every day. Like,
nigga, I can see you walking to the Wico. Nigga,
what are you talking about? Nigga, you just EBT swiping the Wico. Nigga,
you feel me? Like, for sure, you definitely got to kind of create up a little persona for yourself. I'd definitely be telling y'all that too. You feel me? Like,
that's real shit.
Create a persona for yourself in this shit. Because, like,
it got to be something they can buy into.
Yeah.
Bro.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It got to be something that people can
buy into. Has to be believable in a part of you at the same time.
Fake it till you make it?
No.
This is what I said.
Not fake it till you make it.
You see, I talk about money. I preach about money, baby.
He put out the bread. Hey,
Fizz. What that range look like? What Sheila look like outside? What's her name?
Sheila.
Black everything.
I mean, my name out with Sally.
I ain't got my jewelry on, but this 3 carats in my ear is very subtle. You know, I ain't
want to come out. Materialistic. It's about just being like, you feel me? I can get it.
Ain't no fake it till you make it over here, baby.
Keep counting money.
Hey. Ain't no fake it till you make it over here. But what it is, it's whatever you're doing. amplify it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Put it times 10.
Make something more.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. To where motherfuckers are like, oh, I see you. So if you're going to be talking about money, nigga, go spend that shit and make motherfuckers see it. You know what I mean? Oh, like, okay. If you're going to be talking about some positive shit, nigga, go buy 100 backpacks. You know what I mean? Go, yeah. Go spend
no,
it.
No, no.
Yeah. Go spend it. Don't be talking about it. Go spend it. It ain't about faking TV. But if you're going to be talking about this persona, then do that. Like you.
Yeah.
The rap shit, the only thing you was missing was the videos. That's the only thing, bro. You'd have been out the water.
What's
up? Because that's the only thing that's missing when it comes to your tongue. Because that's the only thing you can do. You're not the flexing type nigga, you're not the type of nigga. But if you put the visuals to what you actually talking about, it's over with.
It's gonna go crazy.
It's the same shit. You know what I mean? Like, whatever you put money into it, bro. Whatever you do, you know what I mean? You want to be positive, you want to talk about spending money, you want to talk about anything, bro, go do it. You know what I mean? Like, don't just be rapping about it. And it's going to happen.
I hope you motherfuckers taking notes.
Yeah, y'all better be pinned to the pad with it, man. Notes. Take notes, this man, because it's
jewels. Yeah, so all your fruitcakes.
Hey, look, I got nuts though, my nigga.
Hey, you
I got nuts. Hey, come on, screw over for real, though. Edison.
Bro.
Come on, bro. I understand, bro. I'm for real, need to I'm not even lying, bro. I swear.
This nigga about to lay down on the couch. This nigga like, hold up. Hold up.
Hold up.
He about to lay down. On the couch,
man. It's hot back here. I got this sweater up. I'm trying to take this shit off, but you feel me?
I don't know how you. I didn't even see you put that sweater on, nigga. Nigga dove in the.
I always
Superman.
Worry about equity, man. Just try to get equity or something.
Yes,
I got equity in the rap game. I got a huge catalog that I can go snatch up and sell to motherfuckers. You gotta get equity and shit. Don't just be doing this shit for the free, man.
Yeah, that's the.
So once your tape drop, bro, like you going on tour and shit, or what?
Yeah, I got the show July 12th. The Region Theater, the first ever Cutthroat Festival. You know
okay.
Cutthroat Fest.
Hey, we're here.
Clap it up for Cutthroat Fest.
Y'all better slide through it, man. Grab some tickets and come out and support the homie, man. We're going to be there for sure.
Shit, I got a show. I'm about to leave in the morning. I got a show in Carbondale, Illinois.
Okay.
About to fly out. Yeah, I got a little tour with Jameson, I think, lined up. Okay.
Alcohol?
The singer.
I never heard of who did.
He said alcohol.
Because that was the second time I heard him say Jameson. I was like, alcohol.
What the fuck is Jameson gonna do?
Nigga, do y'all know who Jameson? I don't know who he is.
That
was
funny.
I gotta
that's
get in tune.
Ain't nothing in that cup, bro.
Yeah, he drunk a literal drop.
It's Ramadan, my nigga.
May 17th, Chipper Jones 4. I gotta repeat it to the slow motherfucker. Chipper Jones 4, May 17th.
To the fourth power.
Hey, it's a series. If you looking at this and you haven't even heard 1-3, this is like a perfect time. You know, like trilogies and shit, all like that.
Tough.
Check it out now. It's like Game of Thrones and shit, man. This shit. Long as a motherfucker. So check out 1-3 before May 17th. And get litty.
Chipper Jones.
Do it on the 14th. One on the 14th, one on the 15th. One on the 16th. May 17th, so you'll be refreshed. Like, you know what's going on. Because, like, especially Chipper. Go to Chipper Jones 1, too. You feel me? Was 211 on Chipper Jones 1?
Chipper Jones 2.
Okay. Because I don't know why people look at it like, you like all of me? You like that one? I love 211 on Chipper Jones 2. That's my favorite song.
Thumbs up.
You feel me? I love Chipper Jones.
I produced that, too.
Man, it was in his bag, getting it right.
What else you produce?
In your bag.
What you produce for ASAP Rocky? What you
Jody, Jody produce, the original mode for Schoolboy Q. I produce Champagne Rain, Drug Prescription, Cargo Planes for Currency.
That shit was hard.
Shit.
That resume. Some hits.
Resume.
So y'all niggas better go check that shit out.
Yeah.
Hey, man.
May 17th, Chipper Jones 4 coming out. Joey, man, good looking. I appreciate you coming through to the crib.
Appreciate you feel me? Bro.
Fucking with a nigga.
Hey, man, you already know, man. All love.
Shout out my nigga Fizz. He a cool ass nigga. Shout out Mayan on the camera. Shout out my nigga Eddie. Today visuals, man. Episode 18, we wrapping up when we finish the Henny.
Yeah. Hey, like, subscribe, comment,
ring
that
motherfucking bell, man.
Ring that bell, man. You already know what it is. You already know what it is. Never told a soul, I keep that shit G, I'm sticking to the code. You don't know that feeling when you sliding on that road. With 10 birds stuffed inside the panels of the doors. If you was in my situation, I'd be trying to fold. Looking like you